Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, grade ones. Today we are going to do a new sign. And what is the new sign called? A kasra. What is a kasra? A kasra is a sign that comes at the bottom of a letter. The previous sign we did was called a fatha. And where did it come? It came on top of a letter. Now let's see what sound does a kasra make. What sound does it have? It has an E sound, a short E sound. So that means you do not drag and say E, no, E. Let's go to our two new letters, Noon and Meem. Now if you look at our two new letters, both of them does not have a sign. We need to put a sign on them. And when you put a sign, it makes a sound. Let's see the signs on it. The meme on top has a fatha, so it will be read as m. The meme next to it has a kasra, so it will be read as mi. At the bottom, the noon has a fatha, so it will be read as n. Next to it, the noon has a kasra, so it will be read as ni. One more time, m, mi, n, ni. Let's go to our other two letters, lam and ta. Both of them does not have any sign. We need to put a sign on them so that they can have a sound. Let's see. The ta has a fatha, so it will be read as t. The ta has a kasra, so it will be read as t. The lam at the bottom has a fatha, so it will be read as l. The lam next to it has a kasra, so it will be read as li. One more time. T-T-L-L-I. Let's go to our other two new letters. Fa and ba. No sign on them. We need to put a sign so they can have some sound on it. Let's see the signs on it. The ba on top has a fatha, so it will be read as b. The ba next to it has a kasra, so it will be read as b. At the bottom, the fa has a fatha, so it will be read as f. Next to it, the fa has a kasra, so it will be read as fi. One more time, b, b, f, fi. Now we need to join them and read two letters together. You see the block on top? It is mim with a fatha, m, noon with a kasra, ni. Mani, remember, don't break up. Don't say m, ni, no. Mani. And don't drag, don't say money. No, you're not allowed to drag the kasra. It's a short I sound. Money. Let's go to the one at the bottom. Mim has a kasra. Mi. Noon has a fatha. N. Mina. And one more time. The top one, money. The bottom one, mina. Let's go to our next blocks. Yeah, mim on the top. On the top block, the mim has a kasra, which will be read as mi. Lam with a fatha. M. So we'll read it together, mila. The bottom block, mim with the fatha, m. Lam with the kasra, li, mali. Let's go to our next letter. Ba with the fatha, b. Fa with the kasra, fi, puffy. At the bottom block, b with the kasra, b. Fa with the fatha, f. Read it together, bifa. Now, and this is our sabak for today. We only have, if you count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines for today. Leave the last few lines for tomorrow. We will only read these 5 lines. So let's go over our sabak and let's see how we'll be reading it. Let's start from the top. M, mi, n, ni, l, li, t, ti, mina, mila, mali, mani. Lati, mati, dila, lati, fa, fi, fani, fafi. Remember, we are not allowed to drag. Example, we're not supposed to say mina, mila, no. And you don't drag the last letter to say mina, mila, no. And you're not supposed to break them up. You're not supposed to say mina, mi, La, no, you're supposed to read it as one. When it is joined, you must make sure you read it as one complete word. So from the third line, you do not break up the words. You read it as one complete word. It's important for your fluency. I'll be waiting for your recording. Remember to read A'udhu and Bismillah beautiful before you start. And inshallah, you'll send it very soon. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.